I hope you haven't forgotten about Raptor Lake, which how much buzz AMD is generating right now. Yeah, there are rumors about slight delays, we expect nothing else of Intel these days, but Raptor Lake is still targeting a 2022 release. And since we're closing in on the end of the first half of the year, we're a lot closer to the actual release of Raptor Lake than you might think. I have talked about Raptor Lake before on this channel, but only scratched the surface, and I spent more time talking about Intel's possible release strategy than the actual hardware itself. In this video, I will focus only on Raptor Lake. We will do a deep dive into the CPU and take a look at the changes on a silicon level, including cores, cache, and IPC. Of course, this also includes new 700 series mainboards and a rumored increase in the LGA pin count. Without further ado, let's dive right in. Let's start with the basics first. Raptor Lake is the successor to Alder Lake and will offer an entire lineup, from entry-level to high-end CPUs, both in desktop and mobile. Intel already confirmed that Raptor Lake will be manufactured on the same Intel 7 process node, formerly known as 10nm Enhanced Superfin, and will be socket compatible with Alder Lake systems. Raptor Lake will continue Intel's hybrid design, combining large performance cores with smaller efficiency cores, and Raptor Lake will double the efficiency core count to 16, up from 8 in Alder Lake. As far as we know, the core architecture itself is largely unchanged, but there are improvements, especially regarding cache size. The Golden Cove performance cores in Alder Lake are now called Raptor Cove, while the efficiency cores are sticking with the Gracemont name. To better visualize these changes, let's compare Alder Lake and Raptor Lake on a silicon level, starting with a broad overview. Intel released a couple of beautiful Alder Lake die shots, and it's always mind-blowing to me that most structures are pretty easy to spawn on the silicon itself, even if you are an absolute beginner like me. As we know, Alder Lake is a 8+8 core hybrid design. The 8 large Golden Cove cores cannot be missed, taking up most of the space right in the center of the die. Each Golden Cove core includes 1.25 megabytes of L2 cache. The little Gracemont cores are a bit harder to locate simply because they are actually tiny. They are split up into two clusters with 4 cores each, and these quad-core clusters also include 2 megabytes of shared L2 cache. All cores, big and little ones, are connected by a giant ring bus that is surrounded by a large shared L3 cache. The ring bus is part of the silicon that sits in between the L3 cache slices. Each L3 cache slice holds 3 megabytes, and since there are 10 slices, Alder Lake has a total of 30 megabytes of L3 cache. On one end of the die is the integrated GPU, and the other end holds stuff like PCI Express controllers, physical ports, memory controller, and so on. If you are interested in a really detailed silicon analysis of Alder Lake, check out Lukuza. He's not only much more talented than I am, he also takes the time required to actually figure out all the details. I've put a link to his YouTube and Twitter in the video description. Now, before we compare Alder Lake to my Raptor Lake mockup, let's take a quick look at a more detailed Alder Lake die shot, just to understand where the L2 cache is located. In this picture, it's a lot easier to spot the individual cores, even the smaller efficiency cores. And again, it's crazy to see that 4 Gracemont cores are similar in size to a single Golden Cove core. Starting with Gracemont, the L2 cache is shared between all 4 cores on a single cluster, and the cache is located in the T-shaped structure that sits at the back and in between the cores. It actually holds more than just the L2 cache, including control and interconnect logic, but my point is that an increase in L2 cache for the Gracemont clusters doesn't really increase the size of each individual Gracemont core, only the cache surrounding the cores will get bigger. If we compare it to the large Golden Cove cores, it's an entirely different situation. Here, each individual core has its own L2 cache located within the core itself. That means a not so small part of the area that you can identify as a Golden Cove core is made up of the 1.25 megabytes of L2 cache. And since Raptor Lake with its Raptor Cove cores increases the L2 cache to 2 megabytes per core, the cores itself will also get quite a bit bigger. But enough with our small excursion, let's go back to the bigger picture. And again, check out Lukuza if you are interested in more detailed silicon analysis. Back at our initial Alder Lake overview, I have added my very fake silicon mockup of Raptor Lake. As you can see, all I did was double the Gracemont core clusters from 2 to 4, which as a result also adds 2 more L3 cache slices, because the ring bus needs to connect the 2 new clusters as well. The increase in L3 cache size becomes very obvious when you look at it from the silicon level. Intel basically had no other choice if they wanted to connect 2 more Gracemont clusters. I think you now understand why we just took a closer look at the L2 cache locations, because while my mockup does add the additional Gracemont Esmon cores, it doesn't include the increase in L2 cache for both performance and efficiency cores, as my Raptor Lake mockup is based on a dash of Alder Lake. We don't know if the function units within the Raptor Cove cores will be changed at all, or if the difference to Golden Cove is just a larger L2 cache, but the increase in L2 cache alone will increase the IPC in latency-dependent applications, like games, for example. It's the same idea with the shared L3 cache. Going from 30 to 36 megabytes is nothing to scoff at. It's a 20% increase, and as we know from Zen3D, more L3 cache is always better, especially for gaming. In conclusion, while Raptor Lake might not seem that different on paper, with the same 8 performance cores and twice the efficiency cores, which aren't helpful in most games anyway, if we take a look at the changes on a silicon level, you can see that Raptor Lake has the potential to offer a decent amount of extra performance. The big Raptor Cove performance cores have 60% more L2 cache and access to 20% more L3 cache on top, so in games we should see some nice performance uplifts. But what about productivity? In this area, the doubled efficiency core count will offer a lot more raw performance. Not only does Raptor Lake double the amount of Quasemon cores, but as we just learned, each cluster now has 4 megabytes of shared L2 cache. This is especially helpful in heavy multi-threaded scenarios and might have been a requirement for doubling the core count. Let me explain. During a multi-threaded load, all cores are working at the same time, and that also means that all cores are constantly requesting new data from the cache. If the data isn't stored inside the L2 cache, each core will have to access the shared L3 cache. For Alder Lake, this means that at most you have 16 cores trying to access the L3 cache at the same time and compete for data and bandwidth. With Raptor Lake, it's possible that 24 cores are trying to access data within the L3 cache simultaneously, which puts a lot more stress on the ring bus, maybe even creating a bottleneck. By doubling the shared L2 cache per Quasemon cluster, a lot more data can be stored locally within the L2 cache. And as a result, in heavy multi-threaded workloads, the L3 cache access is reduced, avoiding a possible ring bus overload and reducing the bottleneck. That's also something we have to keep in mind when talking about future Intel products with even more efficiency cores. There are rumors that Meteor Lake or Arrow Lake could double the efficiency core count again to a whopping 32 cores. This means that either Intel has to beef up their ring bus interconnect to support more cores transferring data at the same time, or they have to increase the L2 cache size again. If you made it this far, you have earned yourself a pat on the back. Analyzing silicon can be really useful, but it's not the most flashy part. Performances. And luckily, we already have some real-world data. Cysoft published an initial performance analysis of a Raptor Lake Core i9-13900 CPU, which sadly already has been deleted. I wonder why. But I saved most of the important pictures and read the whole thing. Cysoftware is running two different benchmarks here, comparing the 13900 to a 12900. Both are non-K versions, with a 11900K and a Ryzen 5900X. First, we have the classic Drystone and Redstone ALU and floating point benchmarks, which is a great workload to show the true power of all the little efficiency cores. And as expected, we can see a strong performance uplift, sometimes over 50% compared to Alder Lake. Twice as much Quasemon cores pack a lot of punch if you can work on something in parallel. In the vector-based benchmarks, the performance advantage isn't that pronounced. In the integer test, Raptor Lake even performs a little bit worse, but that might be due to lower clock speeds. Keep in mind, Cysoft is comparing a retail 12900 with an engineering sample Raptor Lake. Before we come to the end of this video, there is another topic I want to discuss. Of course, I'm talking about the socket for Raptor Lake. And if you think it's an easy topic, then think again. It all started even before the release of Alder Lake, when we got first pictures of the LGA 1700 socket. On the socket cover, you could read LGA 70XX and LGA 18XX, prompting a lot of speculation. I have to be honest, I don't have any secret sources or inside information. All of this is just my personal opinion. With Alder Lake, Intel introduced a new LGA 1700 socket, quite a step up over the previous LGA 1200, which supported Comet and Rocket Lake. For me, it's hard to believe that Raptor Lake will increase the pin count to 1800, and I'm not just talking about Intel's strategy here. First of all, Intel created a new socket from the ground up. If this socket indeed does support 1800 pins, why not use them from the very beginning? If we take a look at the backside of a Alder Lake CPU, there are exactly 1700 contact pads. Yes, I counted them. And if we take a look inside a LGA 1700 socket and count the pins, surprise, there are 1700 pins. If Raptor Lake is using 1800 pins more, it would not fit within an existing LGA 1700 mainboard, but Intel already announced that Raptor Lake will be socket compatible. Of course, it would be possible to create a Raptor Lake CPU with 1800 pads that still works on an LGA 1700 socket, because the new extra pins, for example, are just meant to support additional I/O for the upcoming C790 boards. But then a Alder Lake CPU in a C790 board would not support all the I/O. I even made a mock-up 1800 pin Raptor Lake, and there is space on the back of the CPU, but as far as I know, Intel has never put the pads this close to the edge of the PCB. And when I'm looking inside an LGA 1700 socket, I don't really see the space for additional pins. While a few here and there are possible for sure, but 100 extra pins? I think the whole story just sounds so unlike Intel. If you upgrade the socket every second generation anyways, why would you add a generational update in between? Based on the official information we have so far, it is my opinion that Raptor Lake will stick with LGA 1700. But on the other hand, many leakers put their name out there, and it has been repeated more than once. So there must be something to it, right? Only way to find out is to wait for the release of Raptor Lake or first C790 socket pictures. If we do get more pins, you can bet I will try to figure out how and why. I hope you have enjoyed this deep dive into Raptor Lake. I think Raptor Lake is one of those products that at first glance might not seem that appealing, especially with all the hype surrounding Zen 4. But the closer I look, the more I actually like this update, because it's certainly more than just a simple Alder Lake refresh. Aside from the obvious increase in efficiency cores, Raptor Lake doubles down on cache, drastically increasing the L2 cache in the Raptor Cove performance cores, doubling the shared L2 cache of each Gracemont efficiency core cluster, on top of a 20% larger L3 cache. Combined with a slight frequency bump, Raptor Lake has the potential to offer great gaming performance and combine it with an amazing multi-thread performance. Based on how Intel divided the Alder Lake SKUs, we can deduct the Raptor Lake release models if they stick to the same approach. The i9 will feature the full 8 plus 16 core setup. The i7 will most likely drop down to 8 plus 8, same as the previous Alder Lake i9 offered, and the i5 comes with 6 big and 8 little cores. Unlike with Alder Lake, it's likely that the non-K i5 CPUs will still offer efficiency cores, but lower priced processors might be still offered without any efficiency cores. There's so much more I could have talked about. The mobile version of Raptor Lake is supposed to implement a new digital linear voltage regulator to reduce power consumption during low or mixed workloads. And we might get an increase in the base DDR5 spec from DDR5 4800 in Alder Lake to DDR5 5200 with Raptor Lake. A lot to look forward to, and not much time until the September to October timeframe when Raptor Lake is supposed to launch. My number one question still is the rumors about an increase in the pin count, but you know my opinion on that one. If anyone here has more info, please do share. The same goes for your thoughts and ideas on Raptor Lake. Are you planning an upgrade, and how do you think it will compete against Zen 4? Leave a comment down below. If you enjoy videos like this, please leave a like, it really helps the channel. Subscribe for more content, and see you in the next video.